Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at iMovie projects and events. So if you're new to using iMovie, or even if you've been using it for a while, you may be a bit confused about the difference between project and events and where clips go when you import them. And it is very confusing. So let's take a look at an example and see if we can get to the bottom of it. So you really can't do anything in iMovie until you create a project. So here I am, I've got nothing in media stored here, and I've got nothing in projects. So I'm going to create a new project. It's going to be a standard movie project. Now on the left, I can see this sidebar here that shows all the different media I've got. I've got the media in my current project, which is called my movie. The terms movie and project are pretty much interchangeable in iMovie. And I look there, I've got nothing. And I've got a big import media button. I can also look down here in the iMovie library, and this is where events will be stored, and there are no events. So everything is totally empty, and I just have this one empty project to start with. Now there are two main ways to bring video clips into this project. And one is that I can go to File, Import Media, and the other is I can simply drag and drop to here. Of course, I could also click here. It's the same thing as using File, Import Media. Just to make it simpler, I'm going to drag and drop a video into here. And now I see the video clip here as part of my media under my movie. Notice there's still no events that have been created. So where are these events that everybody always gets tons of events in here? Well, it turns out if you import something directly into your project, your movie, with it selected in the left sidebar, it doesn't get added to an event at all. It is simply a piece of media, a movie clip that is only for this project. If you were to create another project, you would not have access to this clip. Only this project, this movie, has access to this clip and any other clips I import into it. So for many people, you never need to mess with events at all. You can simply import video into the project, into the movie, and then forget about events and just create your video here by dragging and dropping from the media area into the timeline. So what about events? How do I get clips into events, and what difference does it make having it in an event rather than in my project media? Well, I can not create a new event here, File, New Event, it's grayed out. It's because I have the project media selected. I'm going to instead click where it says iMovie Library, and now I can do File, New Event. It'll create an event and give it a name that has the date, but I'll just change that to my event. Change it to whatever you want to be descriptive. And now I can import media, and since I have the event selected rather than the project media selected, it will import it into that event. So I'm going to choose three videos here, import selected, and you can see now that I've got my event selected, I've got those three videos. When I look at project media, I've got that other video I selected. If I were to select iMovie Library, I actually will see all four. I see under my movie, one video, and my event, three videos. So it's going to show me everything when I select this. I can also select all events, and I could just see the events. I would see this thing here. I can flip between them, and if I had a second event, I could flip between that. I can select just the single event. I could go back and select just my movie and just see the stuff in there. Now at this point, it's still somewhat straightforward until I go to my event, which is basically just a storage place for clips. I select a clip and I drag it into the timeline. Nothing changes here, but if I go to the project media, to my movie, I see both clips here. So what I've got now is I've got one clip, this one, that's only part of project media. I've got another clip that appears to be part of project media, but is also part of my event. In fact, it's not in two places. iMovie is smart enough to only store one copy of it in the iMovie library. And since I originally brought it in as part of my event, this is where it is. It sits in this folder, if you want to think of it as a folder. But my movie is going to give me a look at things that are in events that I'm using in the current movie, and it's going to give me clips that are not part of any event, but I've imported and are just part of this project. Okay, so then what's the advantage to having clips stored in my event here in the library rather than as part of the project media. Well, if you were to start a second project, and this one's by default called My Movie 1, but I haven't saved it yet, you can see it's got no clips in it. However, the events are all listed here, and there's the three videos that I imported into the event, but not the video that was imported into the other project media. So I have access to videos that are in events in all of the projects. So if you're going to be using your videos and creating a variety of movies from those clips, then store them all in events and then easily access each clip from an event, bring it into different movies. So you've got these two movies here. I can access all the clips in all of the events in either one of these. But in this one, since I only imported this video of Waves into the project media, it's only available for this movie. And that's the difference. But what happens if you made a mistake and you brought this in as part of the project media, but you realize you want to use it in other projects as well? Well, in this view, it's very simple. You just click and drag to the event you want to add it to. Now it's part of that event. Now when I leave this project and go into another one and I select that event, I see this video is there as well. So it's very easy just by dragging to correct that mistake and make the project media part of an event. And iMovie is smart enough not to duplicate the clip. It simply moves it. And this is all just for organizational purposes anyway. Everything's handled under the hood, but you're not actually creating more copies of the same file. So the bottom line is, if you're not into organization at all and maybe don't use iMovie that often, you just want to bring clips into the project media and not use events at all. However, if you are into organization and plan on mixing and matching your clips into different movie projects, then you probably want to go to the media section of iMovie, and here you can access under iMovie Library the clips used for each movie and the clips in each event, and you can zero in on specific events. You can create new events. You can drag and drop items between events. So we could do let's create a new event, and then we can go in here and drag this over to this one, and we can do all sorts of organizational things to put our clips into organized events and then access them in projects. So you have either way. Either you can kind of use iMovie without organizing your clips in iMovie, or you can use iMovie to heavily organize your clips into events before you even start making projects.